trying to get back into the win column after the blowout that was my last game versus Atrix the Matrix. So now I have an opponent in Overlord Zero. Same combination of sets coming up here. Chose to just kind of have a regame. Unfortunately, Atrix was not available for the rematch, so doing another one anyway. He started off here, Overlord Zero did, with Monastic Tutor and getting a shard along the way with the Beacon Shaman. I will... Let's see. I could take the Initiate's Gauntlets. Not sure that's... or the Everbloom. I'm not sure that either of those is really necessary. I'm going to take a Mystic and kind of play it conservative here. I don't think either of those cards are game-ending sort of effects at this point. So, I will take the Gnome Repair Bot. I think that's a... It's not a great card, to be honest, but it is a key... You know, having a Makana construct, sort of a key cog, if you will, you know, in the Makana plan. And, so now, I will take another Mystic. And just kind of slowly waiting and biding my time. There's nothing... Like I said, this is just too exciting. Now, Clockwork Sentry falls into the category of things that are too exciting, so I'll take it. And now I will take another counter on my core and get very close to being able to pick up my actual champion. So what I really need now is another construct at some point to go with the Repair Bot to make my Clockwork Sentry work. Like clockwork. For now, I'll have to settle for Core of the Iron Mind and a Cultist. Keep an eye. He's going to go ahead and start picking up some heavies here. The Lion Heart is pretty tempting. I think I'm going to go ahead and pick up another Mystic. I don't know. I guess I could do a heavy. I've got the Sentry, I've got the Iron Mind, so not a yeah, I'll get a Heavy, but I'm going to pick up another Reputation. I don't want to load down with Heavies here anyway. Yeah, there's that Heavy. That's why I don't like buying Heavies at this stage in the game. At least not the random one or two Heavies when that isn't the strategy I've been going for. So... Lionheart and Click, I assume, maybe. He's got a little close to the makings of a Lifebound deck at this point. I'm not sure if the Click is powerful enough for his tastes, and I can see why a person might pass that. I will probably be passing that as well. Tempting though to... Nah, I'm going to take it. I want to get this center row moving because I'm just one or two cards away from making this deck really flow. Like, mainly a construct. And there is one, so I'm going to hope that that pays off for me. And that I'm going to be able to pick up, excuse me, that Umbral Edge. It's going to require a Terrorizing Fiend, it looks like, which may still be an option for me. Yeah. So everything's still there. So I could really use that Umbral Edge. Let's see if I can get there. And we did it. So that's going to make basically everything go here. And I drew it right off the bat too. Wonderful. Wonderful. Best useless Everbloom Click I've ever bought. It was very instrumental in setting up the board to get me that Umbral Edge. I could care less about the Click. It's there, I'll play it, but it's not something I'm building around at the moment. To banish an apprentice or to pick up three shards and rally enlightened. That's actually a pretty tough call. I'm gonna go ahead and go with the banish. Still early enough in the game that it could matter, that I could actually thin my deck to the point that I could start to draw the cards I really need to draw. Three shards aren't kind of make or break, make or break it. And I'm still gonna have a decent shot this turn at the Corrupted Sage. The big thing is that I'm gonna beat Ezreinx, Erinyx, however you want to pronounce this thing. It's another world, another language. What do you want? Yes, I am going to eat that. That's gonna be just such a huge payoff already. I would like to pick up the Sage, but that being said, there's other ways to get shards. Like that Exhaust Lurker, which is kind of game breaking at this moment. So, pretty good turn coming up here. Go ahead and take out the Glutton. And then I think we will. Oh, and I'm going to get to banish some more too because I've got 10. So, start with the Exhaust Lurker. Blow up his two constructs. Take the Windrake. Banish some starters. And I'm tempted to get the Sage because of the shard. If you can get enough shards, then Ozaya can be mine for free. I'm not sure that either of us are quite in that spot just yet. Rally is also pretty nice, but in an energy set, it's less nice. Yeah, I think the upside on the Sage is maybe just a little bit higher, all in all, with the shard as well. So it's very close, but I'll take it. Overall, the biggest thing I'm doing is creating a lot of power without having to draw a ton of heavy infantry. Which isn't the most impressive thing in the world, but it's so far getting the job done. Gonna go ahead and I think I'll just banish the Ozaya because, like I said, I've already got kind of this power advantage. And there's no particular reason to gamble right now. I feel like I'm at least slightly ahead. Do I want to draw the wormhole? Nah, not necessarily. I bought it because it's 4 for 4. So I'm not going to use the repair bot to pick it up. It'll be better to draw if I can wait around until I've got something like this militia in the discard pile. No guarantee that'll happen, but I'd rather try for that. That way I don't have to banish something from hand. Honestly, if I couldn't have counted into the discard pile. Unfortunately, I could not. I had to just take the shard. Banish this, because I don't want to buy it. And Prodigal is better. Especially for free. Basically, we're very near the end here. In fact, is this going to be it? I've got an 11 power. Well, I'm definitely taking the giant. Best kind of value going on there. There's the Yersin. I'm going to be buying something, but I have a 4 for 3, which may be kind of the max value there. I just can't quite get to the end of the game, I don't think this turn. Let's see, with the whelp. And. Oh, yeah, I can. Okay, yeah. I think that's the best play because it ends the game and then they win. So, I'm going to take the Widow for just enough to end the game. And then I'll take the Hammer. Put the Hammer down in the discard pile there. And then that should be it. So, yeah, wasn't a huge, huge win, but I felt pretty confident that the big turn killing monsters was good enough. So, thanks everybody for watching, and I'll see you back here for game 2.